Let's begin this newscast with the Kashmir issue, which will be taken up for talks at the UNSC today. And let's get you the latest update on Pakistan's letter to the United Nations Security Council regarding India's decision to abrogate Article 370. China has asked for informal closed-door consultations on Friday, which is today, regarding Park's letter at the United Nations Security Council in New York. The informal consultations scheduled at 10 a.m. New York time or 7:30 p.m. IST will see the exchange of views among the UNSC members on Pakistan's Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi's letter to UNSC President and Polish envoy Joanna Ronecka on Kashmir in the aftermath of New Delhi's decision to remove special status for the erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir. The discussions will reportedly be aimed at arriving at a conclusion as to how the Council should react to Pakistan's letter. Pakistan had called for the letter to be circulated as quickly as possible and is reportedly keen on a meeting of the permanent members. Equatorial Guinea, who is a non-permanent member of the UNSC, has said that they have received no instructions on the way forward. Poland, the current chair of the Security Council, had, however, asked India and Pakistan to resolve the dispute bilaterally. The Pakistani foreign minister asked the letter to be disseminated at the earliest and that a meeting of the UNSC should be called, but so far no such call has been taken. Now, Pakistan is keen to have a meeting in which it gets right to speak and record of discussions take place. The consultations will happen without India and Pakistan both not being present, and since it is a consultation process, it will not be part of the UNSC record. Meanwhile, Russia has said that there is no information on any initiative on Pakistan's letter. Dmitry Polyanovsky, first deputy permanent representative of Russia to UN, said that it is open to an informal closed-door discussion, as the issue of Kashmir has not been taken up by the Council for a long time. Asked if Moscow is doing anything behind the scenes, he replied that everybody was doing something behind the scenes as everyone was worried, including Moscow. And so the Union Territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh mark their first Independence Day after the scrapping of Article 370. An interesting sight was also witnessed on the streets of Srinagar yesterday. A resident of Mumbai was seen distributing the tricolour to celebrate the Independence Day, something he has been doing for over a decade to spread the message of unity and brotherhood. He earlier spoke to our correspondent Ishan Vani. Listen into what he had to say.
तो अपने झंडे कहां कहां पे डिस्ट्रीब्यूट किए हैं
आज? जो प्रेम से मांगे आप मांगेंगे तो मैं आपको दे दूंगा, ले लीजिए दो।
तो ये बताइए कि आप आज 370 हटने के बाद आप शायद उसी वजह से आज यहां?
नहीं सर, मैं हर साल पहले आता हूं, 96 से करके हर साल आता हूं।
तो इस बार पहली बार पिछले कुछ बार आप अरेस्ट हुए हैं कभी?
नहीं नहीं, अरेस्ट क्यों करेंगे यार, 15 अगस्त मनाने आता हूं, 14 अगस्त मनाने तो आता नहीं हूं।
Himat represents an average Indian who holds Kashmir and Kashmir close to their hearts. Now, the naysayers might deny the winds of change, might point to the heavy security and curbs in place, but the fact is that the Independence Day brought a new dawn for Kashmir.